If you record videos on Facebook, either live or uploaded to your Facebook page, did you know you can manage all of these videos and the content from the video library? I'll show you how that works in this video. Here we go. So I'm here on the homepage of Rotarian Trainer, and what I want to do is go to the publishing tool. So I'll click here under more and bring up publishing tools. In turn, I can see there on the left-hand side, video library. And these are the videos that are currently there in the library. So you might want to upload an existing video to add to the content. So you'd go here and click upload. And just click on the video you want to upload and click open. Here you can add a title to the video. Optional description, create any tags that are associated with it. Pick a thumbnail so you can pick from the available images that were captured. There's up to 10 there you could choose from, or you could just upload a custom image that better fits the video. So I can click add image. So I've chosen that one. And then you've got subtitles and captions. You can upload or let it auto-generate captions for future uploads. You can add a poll to ask people questions around the video. Tracking would make your video easier to find. Even 360 degree tools. So you can have particular types of video that can be three-dimensional. So if I select that, you've got a checklist. Are you going to make it a premiere, or you can post it as a video? You want to schedule it for later or publish now? And you know, you'll be reminded about the things you haven't done, but I'll just say publish. And now you can see that video is processing, and we'll come back to it when it's ready. And so now you can see it's green, it's gone live. So if I go to edit video, we can again change the things we had before, write some detail about the post itself. I'll just leave there for now. And if you take a video like this one that's previously been recorded, so it's yellow, it's in draft format for now. You've got the opportunity to create a post with a video, or even a watch party where people could join in at a specific time and watch it together. So create post with video, and I'll just leave it as it is and print next, and then again publish now. You got the option there, notice, to allow embedding or not, so you can determine whether someone can put it onto a web page embedded, link back to your content or not. So all sorts of videos. So the library is a really good place to take control of your content. You can see there it says video is used in one post. Well, there's no reason you can't use it in multiple different posts. If I show you now the menu options about the new version of Facebook, so Facebook in 2020, I'll say switch to new Facebook. We're here again in under publishing tools and video library, so the features are still there. And the various buttons here, you've got the insights for the particular videos. You can ask to make it a premiere, so it's announced at a particular time. And you can have a watch party as well. And to do that, you would just go there and start the watch party. So there's lots to explore in video library, particularly in correlation with the Creator Studio parts of Facebook, where you have all the content together in one place. Lots of potential to make sure you use the content to the max. If there's multiple posts you can use it in, you can do that easily. So that's it from me. I'm Paul from PR Wilson Media, your social media personal trainer. Cheers.